Are you looking for a way to organize your Chrome browser because you just have a bunch of tabs open, a lot of bookmarks, favorites, and just a lot of things going on inside of your browser? Well, this extension might help you out to get organized. It's called TabExtend. Now, I know there's a lot of Chrome extensions out there that help you do something similar to this, but this might be even better, or let me know what you're actually using if you think something is better than this. So let's go check it out on my desktop. All right, this is TabExtend's website, and one of the things I want to say out there is that they do have a free version and a lifetime version. Let me show you really quickly what the free version gets you. You get all the features, up to 30 saves, unlimited time, and no account needed. So yes, many people could do with the free version. If that's enough, you're good to go. On the Pro plan, this is the paid one. It's all features, unlimited items saved, multiple workspaces, and daily backups. Backups are super important because if something's going on, you don't want to start over again. Now, this is the free and the monthly version, and there's also a lifetime version. It's $59, and if you ask me, I think it's pretty expensive due to what it actually does. Now, if organization doesn't have a price tag for you, then that's a good deal. For me, I think it's worth it because being organized helps me be more productive. Now, like I mentioned before, a lot of alternatives. If you can do without the $59 deal, then you're good to go. So this is the deal that what you get on the $59. And let's go check out TabExtend. This is my TabExtend. Every time I open up a TabExtend, this is what I'm going to look at, okay? So if I open a new tab, that's what I'm gonna get, okay? So I got my organization done right here. And it helps me out, like I said before, to be organized. In this case, I've created four columns, which I think are the most used for me as of now, okay? So first off, I got my daily. This is what I open up every single time that I open up my browser. So I got my inbox, my Facebook group, and my YouTube channel. I always have these open, okay? And then I look a lot of AppSumo things like that help me out, like link shorteners, AppSumo browser, lifetime deals, marketplace, and all of that. I got these there. My website tools are right here. So I don't have to be thinking about what I need to open if I'm going to work with website tools. Well, I got them organized right here. And Jotform, which I work on a lot. So what can we do with this? First of all, it's the organization, and it's pretty easy to get started. So if I have any of the tabs open, which I do right here, I can drag these inside of any of my sections. So let's just say I wanted this right here, which I already have it there. It was easy as dropping it in. Now, once we have that column, we can do things with that column. For example, if I click on this arrow, it's going to open up all of these four tabs at the same time. And let's go ahead and do it. It's opening them, I'll open them up right now. And as I can open them, I can also close all four of them. So let's just say, hey, you know what? I am done with these. Well, let's get rid of these, all right? So I'm closing them. And this one didn't finish loading, that's why it didn't close. Again, we can go ahead and open up other ones, for example, these website tools. And you're also going to notice up here on the tab, we have this little circle. These are related to the column that we just opened. Again, we have options here. So I'm going to right click it. I can change the color of these so I can locate them. And let's just say that I open up one of these. So I'll open up this one. See how it's highlighted with that particular color? That's to find it. And if I click on the circle, it's gonna close them like that. But it didn't mean that it closed those tabs. It's just smushed, okay? If I click on it, they open up again. So it helps me organize. So let's just say I have a bunch of these columns open, I'll smush them and then I'll open up, I would extend the ones that I want to view. So those are the cool features about this, okay? So organization, and we have these categories right here. So there's a category that's called see later, which I haven't added anything right now. And in my case, I called one tools, and this helps me out organize. So if I need to work with images and video, well, I know I have these tools available or something that has to do with those tools, and I have them organized. Instead of thinking, hey, what type of tools do I have for image editing? Well, I don't have to think about it. I open up here and this is what I've got. Instead of trying to think, hey, what was that name of that deal or that image editor? Well, I have it right here. Automation tools, my web SEO tools, multiple tools, and there's also workspaces. So in this case, I haven't created a new workspace, but I can if I want to. So here's the new workspace. I can rename it if I like, or I can start working on it. So for example, if I want to start with a new workspace, just add that there. Hey, didn't add it. Hold on. Control G, what happened? Workspace one, workspace two. Okay, there we go. So something fishy is going on there, a little bit a bug there. So I can change the icon to this and the title for it and just start dragging these in. Like I mentioned before, you can create as many workspaces as you like in the lifetime version or the month-to-month pro version. It depends what you want to use. So those are some of the features that we can work with. Again, there's also a really neat feature for searching. Let me go back into this one. If I go into search, we have a lot of filters to search around our websites that we have saved right here. So for example, if I want to search for something inside of the tabs that I have, I can search for everything, or maybe it's just a site, a note, to-dos, or snippets. There's also those, I'll show you those in a bit. So these are my sites right here when I've added them and what I can do with them. If I want to create a note, I'll just click inside of here and just say, you know what, for my daily links, just say, check this out later and blah, blah, blah. All right. And I have some options here. That could be a note. I can switch it into a to-do. And now we got a little box to check mark it. To change the color so we can view it. So a little bit more flashy. We have add emojis. So this is add that little face. Copy to clipboard and go ahead and delete it, which I'll delete it because this is just for demo purposes. I can restore it just in case I wanted to bring it back. There's also the features for new groups, like the ones we saw on the top, which are categories in my perspective. Add bookmarks or top sites, site categories, and the settings for this. You have settings, for example, if I click on one of these links, I can make an open it up in a new tab or open it in this one. I chose to open in a new tab because sometimes I don't want to open columns and just kind of select the things that I want to use and I'll open them in a new tab. Instead of opening them in the same tab and then open a new tab and you know, it's easier to just open in a new tab. Sound effects, so if I want to get notified, I have the theme version so I can change it to light if that's what you like. I'm more into dark mode. Clear thumbnails and export current workspace in case you want to share it or save it for backup purposes, okay? So those are kind of the settings that you get. You can also jump into the workspace and manage the account. You're going to see that this is my tab, TabExtend dashboard inside of TabExtend and not my actual browser. And I can view my workspaces here and you can see that yes, they are saved from my browser, okay? So basically that is TabExtend. Like I mentioned before, $59, it's a bit expensive, like I mentioned. And why? Because it does this, which is useful. Don't get me wrong. Like I said, if organization is key to your workflow, then this is good enough, right? It's worth paying that money. But if you are on a budget, you have other things to invest, then you might want to skip on this or use the free version. And like I mentioned before, if you're using an alternative, do let me know in the comments what you are using or what you think is better than this. So I thank y'all for watching. My name is George. This is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.